Okay, so today I want to show the grafting of mango. This is one mango from where I will collect the scion. This is the main plant that I want to graft with the rootstock. Rootstock is the small seedling of the mango, where I will graft the scion from this. That is meaning is that I will cut the stem from here and I will attach with the small seedling. So from here I want to cut now. So this is the cutting secateur, so I will use that one.
Okay, so this is one very nice distance, so I want to cut from here. Okay, this is one. And if I want to attach with some other plants, then I will cut another one extra.
I will use as a scion. This one I will graft with the small seedling, because this mango I saw is very big and giant, and when they even they about to mature, at the greenest stage is very sweet in taste. So this is the reason I am choosing that plant as the scion.
So now I want to show what materials we need. So this is the grafting tape, is usually available in the market, so you can order and you can buy. This is the wrapping plastic, so after completing the grafting we have to wrap with that one to stop the what is called the transpiration, because when I do the grafting there's high rate of transpiration, so we need to reduce that. And this is I am using the largest anti cutter for the making the graft, V-shaped graft. And this is the rope. After that we have to do the tying, and then now I want to show you how to prepare the scion the before.
Okay, so this is the rootstock. It's already very big, supposed to be used a small seedling, but it's in my house, but it is inside the polybags, so we can remove when the grafting is successful, so no problem. So I will use that one as a rootstock. So firstly we need to cut the rootstock from here, you can see, as I will do the grafting here. So just cut. Okay, so for the convenient you can remove the leave some of the leaves from the base, just to make the work convenient. Okay, so now this is I am using the big anti cutter. So firstly we need to give a straight cut along the bark. So if sometimes it may is already cut a big portion, so better we remove some more. Okay, so no need to do it. If if you cut a more section, then you can do that. And this is the scion. This is the scion I have collected from a big mango tree, which is a very nice mango. And you have to remove all the leaves. Okay, so one by one just remove the leaves. This one is big as a scion. Okay, so you have to remove all leaves, because if so many leaves, then the transpiration rate will be very high. When the transpiration rate is very high, so the quickly the scion will dry. So to protect from there, we have to remove all the leaves. Now we have to give the V cut. As the grafting name is V grafting, so we have to remove the bark like that as a V cut. Okay, like that we have to give V cut, so we can make it nice shape. So you can remove some of the section from the bulio and do like that. The cut is depending on how much you have already cut in the rootstock, so based on that you have to cut. Okay, so the rootstock is ready, you can see this V cut. So it's nicely V cut. So now I want to insert this V cut. Okay, so now I want to insert into the V cutter. This is the rootstock, this is cyan. So I have to insert inside. Okay, better to make little bit sharp at the bottom. Have to set accurately. This is very important. Okay, so you can see. Okay, so almost done. So now it is already inserted, and you can see very nicely adjusted. So you have to be careful. This B cut is perfectly adjusted with the cutter. Now we have to tie with the tape, the grafting tape. This one, so like that. You have to do very nicely. Very nicely you have to. Okay, so like that. Very nicely. You have to graft the entire cut portion. That we should not allow to enter any, even any ear. That means we have to make it ear tight. Very nicely you have to tie the entire cut portion. Very nicely. And some portion at the top as well. Okay. You have to do several times. Okay. Okay, so enough. Now you have to cut the tape, and we have to adjust properly with that. This is very sticky, so okay, so this is very nicely done. Now we have to, this is the wrapping plastic, because we have to reduce the transpiration, because if you keep it open, so very quickly it will dry as the sunny days. So like that. Okay. So the plastic, you have to ensure that no leakage. So no leakage into the plastic. Then you have to tie at the below very nicely. Okay. So there is that already. Okay, so now already done the grafting, a big grafting. Actually some type of bark grafting, so but we are cutting as a V shape. So for this is about called V grafting. So this is the rootstock, as our target is to make a mango tree like the cyan, because I have collected the cyan. It's a very nice mango, very giant size mango, and at the greenest stage they are also sweet, and when they ripe they are also very sweet. So we have to wait until 3 to 4 weeks. If we see some of the new leaves is growing at the top shoot, then meaning is that the grafting is success. If no shooting, and also if the cyan is dry, meaning is that our grafting is not success, then you have to redo. You can cut in the bottom. If you see it is not success, so you can cut at the bottom again, and after collecting the cyan from that the same plant or your desired plant. So that's all the grafting of mango as a method of asexual reproduction, as we are converting a general mango. This mango is produced from the seedling, so if you want to grow mango from that plant, we have to wait several years, 5, 6, 7, 8 years sometimes. But if you give the grafting within maybe 1 year, you can see the your new shoot, new branch, they started through the flowering and fruiting as well. So it's very convenient, very easy, and time what is called the time convenient method of converting the small seedling to a mature the plant to be produce the fruit. So that's all from me about the bee grafting in mango.